Alexis Ziegler. I'm one of the founders of Living Energy Farm, which is a farm and a community that runs without fossil fuel. American environmentalism has become very much defined by how do we pretend to be doing environmental things while we make people feel better about living a consumptive lifestyle. But Americans want to consume a lot and feel good about it, so we come up with recycled plastic and hybrid cars and grid-tie solar and food-based biofuels, all these technologies that actually do more harm than good because they're supporting the American lifestyle, whereas most people in the world simply live modestly, and that's what really makes the difference. There's no renewable energy that will let you drive your car, period. Just give it up, it ain't gonna happen. We're lying to ourselves and causing a lot of destruction by pretending we can do that. How do you live without electricity? The answer is simply modesty and cooperative use. That's the kind of the big secret that's not a secret, and that mixing of renewable energy and cooperative use is absolute magic. It just does things you would not have imagined possible. I mean, environmental groups say, okay, we need 80 or 90% reduction in 50 years. That's easy to do right now. I've built houses already that use 90% less energy than the average American home per capita, done it very, very cheaply by combining cooperative use and renewable energy. We have some sort of modern techno toys out here, modern sophisticated technologies, and we tend to layer the technologies. So if the modern technology, which is often a black box, it's a machine we can't fix, we want a simpler machine under that that we can fix. So for instance, we have a modern submersible well pump, but then we also have these very simple, very old, we have 100-year-old pumps out here, these old piston pumps. They're great because they're really easy to rebuild, they're really easy to fix. We have a battery that's over 100 years old. It's an original Edison. It's got Thomas Edison's name written right on the side of it. It's what's called a nickel-iron battery. They're fairly low-output batteries, but they last forever. This 100-year-old battery that we have still works fine. A solar parabolic cooker, and it's just something looks like a satellite dish with tinfoil on it, and you hang the pot in front of it, aim it at the sun. It's very fast, very simple, very easy. You can cook a pot of soup on there just as fast as if it were on a gas stove. There's a lot of these nifty little technologies that are not all that hard to use, and if you moderate your use, if you make your use cooperative, then much more humble energy supplies suddenly become very valuable. And you know, not everybody can make those kind of choices, but hopefully as the economy transitions, we can make those kind of transitions gracefully. People don't want real environmentalism. Real environmentalism is you can't have a private car in a big private house, period. You can't have it. People don't want that. So we're hoping to be able to use some fairly simple technologies to develop a modest but very comfortable lifestyle so we can show it to people and say, okay, we're fat and happy and we're not burning any fossil fuel. So building a movement that has restraint and modesty built into the movement is kind of contradictory or something that's never been done on a big scale. So how that works out is just not clear. We'll see. And just because it's never been done don't mean it cannot be done, but it's never been done on the scale it needs to happen now. Historically, power has always been built at the expense of the future, always. So how do we get people to see that broader focus? I don't know. We'll figure it out. We're working on it.